Section 13.3, troubleshooting tags. Now, this is a troubleshooting step that is reserved for those times when you've just created some tags and for whatever reason tags are not getting data. Heck, we saw a lot of that when we were doing our exercises earlier. We kept creating tags and no results, and it was usually a privilege problem. So, first of all, the tags, they are created, modified, etc. with the system manager tool and the PySMT, but you can also use PyConfig, the tag configurator, PyPoint Builder plugin. So all those are ways of editing tags. The changes, of course, they are stored on the Py server. So again, stating it one more time, even though we may do these edits from a variety of locations, all the Py tags are stored on the PyPoint database. I want to make this, you know, real plain, because, well, you know, some of our information. So, for example, the some of the things we've presented already this week, in which we describe interface tags, tags associated with an interface. Sometimes people get the impression that these tags are somehow stored on the interface. That is absolutely not true. Remember, we don't store the tags here. We won't really store anything there unless there's a buffering situation. No, all of that, all of the tag configuration is stored on the Py server. Just want to make sure that there's no ambiguity about that. It's a very important principle. You know, we don't store the tags on the interface nodes. They're all stored on the Py server. Now, as we mentioned several times, the update manager is going to queue up those changes, if there are changes, and then the interfaces will process those, and then we will process them at the rate of 25 at a time, once every 30 seconds. Now, if you do have a situation which you need to troubleshoot, here's a good set of steps to start with. First of all, if the tag simply has the status of point created, even if it's been 2 or 3 minutes after it's been created, you really ought to check the point configuration. What's probably happened is you probably have either gotten the location code 1 or the point source wrong. See, it's in the point source and the location 1 that we actually make the connection between the interface and the tag. So the first step is, if there's no data showing up, look in PyPC.log and see if the interface picked up that tag. You actually see that it says, you know, tag X is added to the interface. Now, if that's true, the log should indicate if it was loaded with or without error. If it simply says it's been added to the interface and there's nothing else, then it should be getting data. If not, you'll see what the error is. But if you don't see any mention of the tag in PyPC.log, again, check point source and location 1. It's very likely that you somehow did not make those agree with the configuration on the interface. So in fact, the interface does not know that it's supposed to start scanning that tag. Now, we've got a helpful little utility for troubleshooting tags, and that is this stale and bad points plugin. Let me demonstrate. If we go into points, stale and bad points, this is where when we execute this, it's going to go out and look for any points that are simply stale, and by stale we mean that we're not getting any data. Okay. So this is going to show anything between this 4 hours, anything between 4 hours and 365 days where the data is stale. Now, by 4 hours and 365 days, what we mean here is this has to be stale for at least 4 hours. That's the minimum. So if any of these values have been stale for 4 hours, they will show up here, indicating that there's something wrong with them. And then the maximum of 1 year, the reason we have that is because sometimes there's a tag that you just, well, you've kind of given up on it. It has been stale for longer than a year, so you'd just like to ignore that. So anything longer than a year of stale data, we're just going to ignore it. So for example, if I can change, as we do in our directed exercise on the next page, we can change this to, for example, 30 minutes. And let's see, how many stale values did we get? We got a fair amount of stale values here. That if I go ahead and set this to 30 minutes and then search again, this is now going to find just those tags that, or all of those tags that have at least had stale data for 30 minutes, which that's kind of short. So there are some legitimate tags that may have no data for 30 minutes. So it's a nice little utility for helping you find tags that are in trouble. Now, if you come in one day and you find that there's simply a flat line in ProcessBook, it could be an indication, first of all, that the interface has stopped abnormally. Now, by abnormally, what I mean is it stopped in some kind of a way in which it did not have the time to write the status of interface shutdown when it shut down. So perhaps it crashed without being able to write that during a regular shutdown. Or, of course, it could be simply that you forgot to configure that. The slash stop stat, that is making reference to this right here. Internally, that's used with the slash stop stat switch, as you can see in the balloon help there. Okay. You can also see this kind of a problem if you've got some kind of a network communication problem between the server, and as a result, the interface has problems. Now, that will immediately show up in the IO rates, which will fall to zero, and you can also help detect that using ping. So you can ping the interface and see if the network is not available. What we suggest over and above all this is to use the interface status utility. Now, if you've configured interfaces before, the interface status utility is really very simple to configure. In fact, I mean, we call it a utility, but it's kind of like an interface itself. It runs and acts like an interface, and it simply watches the activity of what we're calling a heartbeat tag. And if that heartbeat tag from a PI interface stops updating, then we change the value of the tag for the interface status utility, and we say that this is no longer collecting data. So it's a nice little utility you can use. We don't really teach it in the System Manager 1 class. We do teach that in our System Manager 2 class. But again, it is available to everybody who uses PI, and it's available for download from our tech support website.